Parise got tangled up a little bit with McKinnon, and there was some real back and forth going on.
Bit of a turnover down low, turnaround opportunity, and it's knocked away. Koivu sends it out front, score! Parise with a redirect up top, and Minnesota has taken a 1-0 lead on a play that looked to be broken up.
Parise was saying that he hasn't felt this good since his days in New Jersey. If he can stay healthy and do what he's been doing since he came back from the injury late last year, this is a different Minnesota Wild club. Haskinen broke his stick. That allows Suter to bank it off the side glass, back to center ice. Here's Parise with the empty net, rolls it towards the goal, and score! That would have been a goal anyway as Klingberg interfered with Parise, but Zach Parise gets the empty net goal, and the Minnesota Wild have a 3-1 lead with a minute to go.
Brodin holds with the skate, gives to Zucker, final seconds of the power play. Spurgeon centers, Koivu fires, Parise scores!
The Tampa Bay Lightning right down here. The Koivu takes a shot and it squirts through the equipment of Vasilevsky. And Parise is good as gold from that point. Top of the crease and just pokes it home.
Finney, now the boards for Garrison. Garrison can't get it out. Bouncing puck, here it comes, the shot from Dumba. Opportunity for Parise, scores! Zach Parise at the side of the net will get his first power play goal of the season.
He rips it, stops the puck right there, Parise does. On the first shot, brings it to his stick and pumps it home.
Granlund's got nowhere to go. Niederreiter bumps for Spurgeon over to Koivu. Now down low, the touch pass, and they score on the rebound. It's Parise with a power play goal.
Terrific patience by the Wild, moving it around. Sharks were doing an extremely admirable job of staying in the passing lanes. Joe Pavelski's right there, but it's a 2-on-1 down in front of the net, and ultimately Parise puts it home. Nice little job there for Nino Niederreiter, creating a distraction in front of Martin Jones.
Parise fanned on the shot, some back pressure from Toffoli. Doughty gets to the puck. Indirect pass off the end boards. Parise in space, backhander scores! Campbell got a piece of it, but it trickles into the goal. And Minnesota takes the lead on a goal from Zach Parise.
If the goaltender gets a chance to get set, maybe, but he has to go side to side. When you do that, many times, tweeners opens up, and that's what happens on that play right there. Parise, assist on the power play goal, sixth goal of the season, 2 points on the night, and the Wild lead it by one.
Good read there by the Blues defenseman. And now Brodin a pass. Glove down by Parise for Niederreiter, a shot, rebound, they score! Off the crossbar, right to Parise, and he ties the game.
And then right off the crossbar, a knuckleball and another spin around a backhand pass. So he starts the play with a blind backhand spinorama pass, and he ends up scoring the game tying goal on the same play.
Buffalo, four consecutive wins, 8-2-2 over their last 12. Here Parise takes over a loose puck. He's in, he scores!
Well, it's communication on the Sabres' part. They made a pass to a player that was jumping over the boards for a line change right there. And Zach Parise says, thank you very much. I'm going to at least get a high-quality scoring chance. And he banks in his eighth of the season in his game back after missing one due to illness. And what a shot this was.
A long clip shot. Oh, it was deflected just wide. Koivu. With Parise to the front of the net, Koivu got it there, they score! Zach Parise, that's the same play the Hawks worked. And Parise able to redirect the pass for a power play conversion.
Puck takes a crazy carom right in the blue paint again, as you mentioned, Pat, just like the goal that Taves scored. Get it to the blue paint, strong on the stick. And it's a 2-1 game.
Now it's Suter across to Spurgeon. Ahead to Parise. Toward the empty net. He scores!
Koivu has it back. Niederreiter out to Spurgeon. Dumba fires high and wide.
And they score! Parise on the rebound!
The power play goal puts Minnesota in front.
Dumba to continue to shoot the puck from this side, and he misses high. It deflects up and away, and we'll see Parise get involved right here, and he's able to tap it in off the shaft of the stick, bounce it into the net. That is not a high stick.
Walking out of the corner, Niederreiter dumps it behind. A quick attempt there by Koivu. And Bobrovsky finds the puck behind him. The Wild come right back. Deficit now two.
Now Zach Parise for the Wild, the leader, if not one of the big time leaders.
These guys are going to work hard. They're going to crash the blue paint. Parise fights to get position right here. You can see it's jammed up on one side. Looked like the puck's going to be frozen. It's not. It's kept alive. And there's Parise attacks on the backhand. It finds a little daylight behind Bobrovsky, and it lands on the backside of the net.
Minnesota gets the game's first power play at 12:02 of the opening period, looking for the equalizing goal. In the two games against the Canucks this year, the Wild are 3-for-7. And here's an early chance. They score! Dumba with the blast. Might have been tipped by Parise. And the Wild have tied the game at 1.
Mikko Koivu gets it back. There, Parise gets it. That would have gone wide, and Parise on the backhand tips it up and over.
And now Ryan Suter to Spurgeon. Long lead pass, sends Parise in alone. Parise scores!
Wow, some Wild players are having some big nights here. Parise adds a goal to a two-assist night.
Niederreiter. Hands it off to Parise. His long shot knocked away by Reimer. Rebound, he scores!
Unforced error, if there ever was one. It might have deflected off the defenseman, but when the puck comes off the back wall like that, yeah, it does. It deflects off the defenseman and then the blocker. So really should have handled that a lot cleaner. Ends up playing flipper with it, and it finds its way to get into the net. Parise didn't have to hit it a second time. Reimer did the work for him.
Now Parise to Staal. He takes a look, trying to center one, picked off Dealey. He lost it. They score. Granlund able to found a loose puck after Dealey thought he had things denied, and it squirts away from him. The Wild with a tying goal.
Boy, a couple of big time stops from Colin Dealey. And then eventually Parise's there, Granlund's there. And the puck ends up into the back of the net after the wraparound from Erik Staal.
Koivu into the Pittsburgh zone. Koivu around Rikkola. Plays to the line for Parise. Parise weaves inside. Parise, a shot, he scores!
Well, Koivu took it into the zone, but watch Parise come off the half wall here. I mean, this is a great effort. Splits the defenders, cuts to the middle, and banks one off the pipe. That's the kind of effort that you need. It's the kind of accuracy you need on the shot.
Cunning lifts it right back in. Tights it. Knocks it to the corner. Austin Matthews up with it. Cut off by Coyle. Here's Coyle over to Parise. Scores! Zach Parise with a top corner shot. And the Wild are out front 4-3.
And he's got a great release, and he just throws it up over top of Hutchison for his 18th goal of the season. But the defense have to have at least a short outlet if that long play isn't available, and it has not been available for the defense here this afternoon. And there's been all kinds of giveaways because of it, and the puck was rolling when he got that up over top of the goaltender.
But it's knocked away for Cunning. Rebound scores! And the Wild have taken a two-goal lead on a goal by Zach Parise, who has a three-point game.
Cunning's going to step out and try and wrap that. It goes off the left pad of Anders Nielsen, and then right on the back door, Zach Parise.
Now Belpedio goes tape to tape to Parise. Drops it back into his own zone for Brodin. Then back to Parise. Aberg ahead to Rask. Aberg a shot, and that went just wide. Centers, Parise scores!
The great follow-up by Aberg, and eventually Parise will get the Wild up 2-0.
Granlund turning. Dispersion to Suter. Suter in the stall. Or Coyle, that is, trying to jam it in front of the net. It's on the line. And Minnesota says they've scored. The light never came on.
The referee says it's in, RJ.
Okay, so that means the game is tied.
Yeah, he was right on the back of the net watching it. He came across and made the direction that the puck could cross the line.
Kill unit for the Devils. Severson takes his spot alongside Andy Green. Off the draw, scramble for the puck. Coleman and Zajac, the forwards on the kill. Green battling along the near wall, sees it held in by Suter. His shot deflected, they scored! Zach Parise was in front, a power play goal, and the Wild have the lead.
So tough to kill back-to-back consecutive penalties when you take them. It's taxing on your penalty kill. You know, the second time around, the Wild are going to adjust this time. Simplify the quick little snapshot from the point from Suter, and then Zach Parise with his 22nd of the year.
Centers, bouncing puck lands on the stick of Granlund. Granlund turns it back for Minnesota. Works his way up high. Down low, Parise scores!
There's so many options in front of the net that Stolarz probably cheated a little bit there. He figured, well, Parise probably will go to the front of the net like the Wild have been doing, and instead, Parise does the right thing, banks it off his shoulder, and puts one in there for the Minnesota Wild.
Mestikov got back to stop him. Ooh, Brady Shea collided with his own man, and the Wild took the puck and score and lead it 3-1.
Zach Parise ended up with the puck all alone in the slot. And he went in, he had so much room, no one was around him, and he just faked it on the forehand, went to the backhand, and beat Lundqvist. Shea right here gets tripped down by, I believe it was Stahl, Eric Stahl. There it comes again. He'll make a move.
Yeah.
There's the trip. Down he goes, and Parise ends up with all that time and space and room.
Now it's up to Zach Parise. 40% in his career. He'll delay. And he scores! Zach Parise leaks it through. He'll see Saros.
Able to open up Saros and then slide it ever so smoothly through the legs. Wild will keep this group on the ice other than Spurgeon, who heads to the bench. Donato into the corner. Suter centers for Parise. He scores!
Parise's had some opportunities. He's been snake bit a little bit with some blocks and goalposts. But look at this. Between the legs and finds the outside of the goaltender's pad. He's being tied up here. Was a little handcuffed on the play. What a goal by Zach Parise as he uses what he had left. And that was getting the stick between the legs and firing it to the other side.
Fiala sends it back up high for Suter. Suter works to the middle. Spurgeon sneaks down low. They score! Zach Parise on the deflection, and we're even 1-1.
Watch him reach across the other side of his body and just deflects it downwards past the blocker of the goaltender Grubauer. This is just a skill that a lot of players continue to get better at, but Zach Parise has always been good at it.
Try to escape Little. Now he's chased out by Laine, and he feeds Patterson. Patterson's goal in Vegas, to which Wes referred moments ago, snapped a streak without a goal of 130 games. Here they score! It deflected in off of Comrie. And the Wild have the game's first goal.
Great Patterson. You can only hope to contain him. Nice, he picks up an assist on that goal. This is a big game for the Winnipeg Jets. That is a situation right there that cannot give this goalie a ton of confidence.
And controlled by Hayes at center. Hayes has it knocked away by Suter. Parise whacks it ahead, trying to send Stahl in. Loose puck, Parise scores!
Zach Parise's got there a few times, does a great job of beating his defenseman, number 7, to the back post. Eric Stahl does a great job of tying up the defenseman's stick, so that allowed Zach Parise to get in on that one.